Hello students, welcome to the session. Today we will be talking about forensic medicine, and I will give you a few points to introduce you to the subject of forensic medicine. So we learn about few important terms and terminologies which are related to the subject, the relevance, that is how we can apply the knowledge of forensic medicine to the practice of medicine, what is the role of forensic medicine in everyday life, branches of forensic medicine, and certain historical aspects related to the subject. So we all live in a civilized society. We are the citizens of the country India. So we have a certain crime rate in this country. So every crime ought to be punished, and criminals have to be taken to task. So we need a certain code in the law to define the punishment and to prescribe the punishment. So what exactly is a crime? A crime is an unlawful act which is against the law, so hence there is a certain punishment which has to be given to it. So it is punishable by the state or the authority. So what are the examples of crimes or offenses? We are talking about injuries. It could be mechanical injury, it could be regional injury, firearm related injury, it could be related to murder, suicide, road traffic accidents or sexual offenses, or circumstances where poisoning is involved, etc. All these are crimes. Now, who's a forensic expert? A forensic expert is somebody who, by his experience and knowledge, due to his educational qualification and knowledge, can be engaged in the dispensation of justice. That is, they are involved in administering the justice to the acquired, because they have acquired certain scientific temperament. They have developed or cultivated an attitude such that they can unearth crimes. That is, they can provide the justice. They are involved in the administration of justice. They are applying their medical knowledge in order to help provide justice. Okay, so what is the meaning and the scope of the word? So there are two words here. So one is forensic and the other is medicine. So if you wanted to elaborate the word forensic, it is derived from the Latin word called forensis, which implies something which pertains to a forum. Right, a forum is like a platform or a meeting place where legal matters used to be discussed, and this is according to the history. That is, in Rome, they would have platforms where they would have public discussions going on in order to classify the crime and in order to provide punishment to certain cases where crime was involved. So the word forensic basically conveys any issues which are related to the debate in a court of law. And the word medicine is considered as a science for preserving health and for effecting the cure. So the term forensic medicine and the subject has basically emerged from the interaction of two major professions. So the law and the medicine. So it is basically the application of medical and allied knowledge or paramedical knowledge to aid in the administration of justice. So it denotes the medical aspect of the law. So in the Europe and US, the term legal medicine is more commonly used, which is the application of medical knowledge for the solution of legal problems. Forensic medicine was earlier also known as medical jurisprudence. So the word jurisprudence basically means juris is the law, prudentia is the knowledge. So it is the knowledge of the law in order to solve or in order to deal with medical practice, right? So it discusses the legal responsibilities of the physician with reference to medical negligence. So what is medical negligence? It is the absence of reasonable care and skill when it comes to practicing medicine. Consent. What is consent? It is the a voluntary agreement between two or more parties such that they agree on the same terms, right, and in the same way, and it has to be intelligent and informed in order for it to be legal. Then we have the rights and duties of doctors and medical ethics or moral principles which should guide people who practice medicine, right? So we have the code of ethics. So all these are the legal aspects of medical practice. So we have two words. We have forensic medicine and we have medical jurisprudence. So one is the legal aspects of the law, the legal aspects of medical knowledge. The other would be the legal aspects of medical practice. Okay, with the enormous advances in knowledge and technology in the last few decades, we have fields in forensic medicine. We have something called forensic odontology, which is the study of teeth. and forensic osteology, which is the study of bones, forensic biology, ballistics. Ballistics are firearms and how they are, how they are used in crime and how they can be used as evidence. Forensic psychiatry, which talks about mental illness and how it can be useful in carrying out justice. Forensic serology, etc. They have come to be recognized as specializations in themselves. Now, objectivity and impartiality are the two characteristics which are attributed to forensic experts. Objectivity is they have got to apply their knowledge in such a way that they are not swayed by their emotions, or they don't have a particular so objectivity and impartiality, that is, they just have to they are involved in administration of justice. They should not have personal opinions. They should not allow clouding of judgments to affect their practice. Okay, and caution, foresight, wisdom are of course required in order to successfully carry out any practice. Now, is a medico-legal expert a detective? Now, this is a question which any student would have. So the answer would be no. A medico-legal expert is not a detective, although his or her knowledge and intelligence is used to solve a crime. They are not going to encourage the accused people to talk about their crime. Now, who's an accused person? Somebody who's involved, or somebody who's arrested by the court because they have committed a certain crime. However, we have a trial in a court of law, and only after the proceedings take place in a court of law and it is proven that they have actually, once it is proven in a court of law, they would have to serve their punishment. But otherwise, they are just accused until they are proven to be either guilty or innocent, right? So the forensic expert is not going to encourage an accused person to talk about the crime for which they are charged. Remember, that is the duty of the police, right? The police are somebody, they are the task force. They are supposed to carry out the investigation into suspicious cases where there is unnatural death involved, right? So the duty of a forensic expert is just to apply their medical knowledge to gather the evidence to help the court of law to get to a particular conclusion, right? Now, is forensic medicine an exact science? Not really, because we always have unexpected results which may be produced due to biological variations. So there is a lot of the aspect of the subject which is basically practical. So it could vary depending on the circumstances, depending on biology, right? So I would like to quote a sentence. Medicine is a science of uncertainty and yet an art of probability. Right, so we presume certain things to be true, however it needs to be proven, right? We need to give evidence, and only then can we actually regard it as evidence. Okay, now there is a role of forensic medicine to prove certain points in the law to aid in justice. Let's say there's a case where there's violation of human rights. So we need the knowledge of forensic medicine in order to guide the people who are involved and to provide the justice.